Hello and welcome to another Jersey Filmmaker episode. I'm Anthony Ceratelli, and today I want to talk about the pros and cons of freelancing as an individual versus starting a production company. I personally do both. I take on clients and projects as a company and do everything from pre-production through post, but I also take gigs as a freelancer and get contracted out to do a specific task on other people's projects. I wish I could say I only took on projects as a company, but I don't yet get enough recurring work from the clients that I do have to sustain the company monetarily. So freelancing as well helps complement that. My overall experience so far is that owning a company is expensive. Maybe not so much the physically starting and just owning part, but definitely when trying to manage and grow. To just straight up start a company, you have the generic legal fees of starting the LLC or whatever type of company you choose, any bank fees to open an account to keep your monies in order, whatever gear you deem necessary to own, whether that be a camera or audio equipment or a computer to edit, etc. And lastly, I would suggest, but I guess it's not completely necessary with platforms like Vimeo and YouTube nowadays, but to have a website to display your work. So with those few things, you can technically own a company, and that's not a huge monetary commitment to get it started. But now let's look at sustaining and growing the company. We'll create a fictional company with some yearly numbers for effect. Let's call it Official Professional Productions, OPP. So OPP, how can I explain it? Let's say OPP is based here in the New York, New Jersey area. This is important because numbers can vary tremendously based on the location of your business. Now you could start your business out of your home, but OPP is looking to grow quickly and wants to get an office space. So they decide on a 2,000 square foot space, so they have a little studio space to go along with their offices and desks, and rent is going for $3,000 a month, a steal here in New York. Let's say you, the owner of OPP, is a cinematographer. You probably want to hire an editor and a producer, or a couple of predators to keep on staff. Let's leave it at that to keep a small core team, and we'll say you pay them an average salary of about 50 grand a year. I'd assume you'd offer them insurance, so let's make that a nice even $10,000 yearly expense for the company. Subscriptions, software, stock footage, audio, website, Vimeo, Dropbox. I mean, you'd be surprised with what you end up needing to physically do your work, to display your work, and to protect and transfer files for clients. Now let's look around the office for the basic things you'll need for you and your employees. How about some high-end computing to manage the massive files you'll be working with? Definitely hard drives. These things pile up the more and more work you get, and you're gonna wanna back them up two or three times. Maybe you want a RAID system to be super protective of your files. Let's add another couple grand minimum. Furniture, actual desks and chairs and filing cabinets or whatever else you need. Let's go super cheap and say $3,000 to fill out the office. I'm not even gonna get into gear because that can vary so much, so you can go as big or as little as you want. Just be sure to add that in your mind when trying to compute what it costs to start your company. Now that we have all this, how about some clients? The good news is with the internet and social media these days, you can do this fairly cheap, but OPP is trying to grow a little faster, so they put a moderate amount into advertising at $5,000 a year. There are a million more expenses that I promise you will incur, but this is enough to get the point across, so let's total up the operating costs of your small but rapidly growing company. Some of these numbers were startup expenses, so I'll separate those. But the yearly operating costs for OPP between rent, salaries, subscriptions, insurance, and so on are over $150,000. And guess what? That doesn't include paying yourself. If you want to bring home at least what your employees are and want to be insured and all that good stuff, now we're talking over $200,000 a year. So this is why you need some really good recurring clients or maybe one really big client to sustain your company. Then hopefully you add on more and more to help your company grow and really put yourself over the top. Now freelancing. What do you need to be a good freelancer? Yourself, some gear, and a good personality. Your biggest expense would be gear. You can definitely own gear to consistently shoot with, but it's not always necessary because you can get hired to operate other people's and rented equipment. But if gear is your biggest expense, then the only other thing you need to do is put yourself out there. Meet and connect with people, take as many jobs as you can early on, be friendly, and try to get hired over and over. In my opinion, anyone can buy gear. A lot of people can do a good job, but if you're a great person to work with, I promise you, you will get consistent work. Real quick, I wanna back up to OPP and just reiterate that I made that company and the numbers up. Every situation varies tremendously and the costs can be way more or way less. So $200,000 or whatever amount of money doesn't necessarily make you a super successful company. There's lots of other things that go into it. That's my disclaimer. So my overall opinion on freelancing versus starting a company is that it's probably easier to start as a freelancer, build yourself a reputation and clientele, and then transform into a company. However, if you're lucky enough to have the contacts to get a lot of work up front, or you have the financial backing to support a few years to really let your company develop, then hey, go for it. But either way, be sure that you have a really solid business plan so you're not throwing your money or anyone else's money away, because that's just not good for anyone. So that's all for this episode. If you liked it, please click the like button, subscribe, and hit the little bell so you get alerts to all future episodes. Of course, if you have any comments or questions, you can leave them below or contact me on my social medias at Jersey Filmmaker. Thanks as always for watching, and I'll see you next time.